Right, seems we're in Gosport, folks. I know we've got runners and everything. Bit sneaky flips there, folks. So yeah, mad.
Just pixelate out their faces.
It'd be funny. Blur them out, folks.
Look at the birds attacking the dog.
Oh wow.
What?
Oh, he was.
The bird was attacking the dog. Look how close it is.
Oh yeah, I see it now.
Dogs are hard enough to swim.
Look. Oh!
I've never seen that before.
Oh.
He's a bugger, isn't he?
The old crows, folks.
It's all happening in Gosport then, isn't it? So, yes, we're going to have some...
He's gone for a paddle.
We're going to have some food, folks. Knock some of this up in this car park. We've got an hour.
Another one.
So, yes.
The problem with that is you've then got a very big wet dog to put in your car.
Yeah.
Mad, isn't it? It really is cold. I can't believe it's 10th of October, folks.
There. Looks like a castle.
Got the old winter hat out. And, yeah. So, Tom here, folks, brought us to Gosport, Portsmouth. With some locations. Jesus, folks. ICAS researcher.
Mm. Quite a few locations, haven't we?
Yeah. There's quite a few on there. Right, let's get the cooking going, Chris. Done it, folks.
Could leave it out there, couldn't I?
Yeah.
It's freezing, isn't it?
Right, so before we go exploring today, folks, we're going to have some food. What is it? Bacon and...
I think it was a full English, I think.
Well, we've got bacon and egg.
Right.
We do have beans, so we could have, like, toast, bacon, egg and beans if you wanted a full breakfast. Or you can have a sandwich.
Sandwich?
Yeah, we'll do the full Monty, folks, shall we? Yeah.
What, full breakfast?
Yeah, why not? Good start to the day, innit? We're all feeling
We've got enough time for this.
Yeah, it'll be all right.
Are you having a hot drink? Hot chocolate or anything?
No, I'll have hot chocolate later.
Throw
up the old the jet
oil. And there's one for tomorrow.
Right. We're all starving hungry, folks.
Wow, there's like ice on the bacon.
Is this smoked bacon?
Yeah, I don't know. Yeah.
Smoked bacon's the best one, folks.
Oh, wow, that's thick.
One.
We've got a shovel thing somewhere.
We've got all the tools all neatly prepared.
All the tools.
It's like Kay's cooking, isn't it?
It is.
It's better than Kay's cooking.
The equivalent of Kay's cooking.
Yeah. Real Kay's cooking. This is Chris's cooking.
Check out Kay's cooking.
Yeah. I've moved outside, folks. So yes.
Well, since Tom's having all that. It was like, do you want a sandwich?
And yeah. Sorry, I've been toasted.
Toasted sandwich, Chris.
It's just cooking gloves on. Go for the flame grill toast. It's done then, isn't it?
I do like toast. It's not quite
the same. Absolutely mad, isn't it? Right, so I don't know, what would you recommend, folks? Just a good way to do it? Took the paper off, that's one thing, eh?
Well, we have the toast. The toast is done. Toast is brilliant. I don't know if you filmed that, did you?
Yeah, that's all right. Yeah. That's nothing to do with me this time. It's Chris talking.
Now we have the tray for the bacon.
We decided to get rid of the tin, folks. Because
ow, that's hot.
Watch that. You want to get some gloves, folks?
It was hot.
They've decided to ditch that because obviously it's burning the bottom, wasn't it? Watch it. Is it hot?
The glue's sticky on the side now.
Oh, right.
Right.
What, toast?
So is it burnt? Check it out. That's bacon.
All right.
That's done, yeah?
Yeah, we need the eggs now, folks.
Oh, the beans are burning.
Put both tins in. Or
How many tins of beans do you want?
Before you say it, folks, those eggs are black like that because of the bacon's been in it. So if hell on, earth are there, it's apparently it's an in a pan. But can't say that.
I think you just did.
But no, that's fresh ingredients here, folks. Lovely.
Fresh ingredient. Well,
did you go and get them?
They came out. I'll tell you what. When we did that, Rendlesham, that was quite good. Literally drove along the side of the road, bought eggs.
Yeah.
Off, you know, like someone fresh. And it did taste really good, didn't they?
It did.
Instead, we have the good quality Tesco battery eggs.
The beans are burning, mate.
I've turned them off. Off the black ones. They're all
right. Right, let's tend to these eggs, folks. Let's tend to the eggs.
Do you want to put the eggs on the tray? Where are you eating? Are you coming
in? I'm just going to stand here. Oh, no, we've got to sit over there. Cowboy breakfast, folks. Tom's buttered the bread and the toast. Eggs are looking good. And yeah, tea's cold. Lovely. It is. I can't believe how cold it is here. Like when I was in Dover, it weren't too bad.
Out.
Yeah, and the sun's out, and it's like.
On my phone, it says it feels like 7 degrees.
Yeah. That camera bodies feels really, really cold, like refrigerated. Jesus,
surprising,
folks.
It wasn't in the van overnight.
Look at that for a sandwich,
wow.
Folks.
Wow.
Do you want some ketchup? That is mad, isn't it? So that's a true.
Does it taste as bad as it looks? That's the question.
Sun in the camera lens. It's true IKS breakfast, folks. It's cooking on the move.
Should we put, some boiling water in that, should we? Or should we just wash it up tonight?
Yeah, we ain't got time for all that.
No.
Right, let's go, folks. Let's eat this. Seat belts on. Dangerous buildings. That's the museum. Diving museum. Nice.
Turn left in a second.
Look at that.
Should be a housing estate here.
It is that cold, folks, because the batteries are drained.
We just got to find somewhere.
Find somewhere to park, folks. In the housing estate.
Yellow lights.
Look, there's a entrance to a manor house, it looks like. Well, remember we were talking about disguises, folks? Well, I'm in one again today. This is not my real hair. As you know, I don't have any hair, hardly anyway, so...
I thought that hair stuff you were using, I thought it was grown.
Bushed up, but bushes in a different colour, because apparently you get this hair treatment that makes bald-headed men get their hair back, but if you don't get the right colour, this is what happens.
How much did it cost you?
Nah, it's free.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
So right ahead of us there, folks, it looks like a bunker. Looks like a Cold War bunker. I reckon that's a generator room.
Oh, it says ground down, so it's going to be with the barracks over the other side of the road.
Look at the old little,
the wheels, the dope.
The wheels, they've got the little... It's good, isn't it? Quite an oldie though, I'd say it's probably like 60s, 70s, that building.
Yeah.
Mad, this, folks.
I don't think it was down here, unless it was right down there.
It was...
Did you say we get from around the back? So, we might as well just go around the back.
But what are we looking for? Is it something we know the name of?
What's it? It's the whole barracks on the roundabout.
Right.
Over here.
What?
That's the bit that we saw.
Right, okay.
So we might as well walk around the front.
Yeah.
Yeah, we've got quite a long walk.
Yeah, that's fine.
Right, so that diving museum is right up ahead then. It's an old battery. Do you remember the name of the battery, Tom?
Number 2 Stokes Bay Battery, I believe it is.
Number 2 Stokes Bay Battery. It looks abandoned at the top, so...
Back there, there's some masonry sticking out under where them caravans are. And we were just saying, I reckon there's more bits of it.
Oh, right.
You know, some of the site's been repurposed.
Do want to look at this museum at some point.
Yeah.
Went past it about 5 times now, hasn't it?
Yeah.
A cannon outside it.
Is that a real one?
Looks to be.
I'll get out of the light. Yeah. Oh,
I thought the camera had gone off then. Was it a naval ship gun?
Yeah, I think so.
It's too much to read.
Can't really see that, folks. You'll meet. Let's have a look.
Not enough pictures.
Huh? Yeah, not enough pictures. What are those chained down?
Yeah.
MOD sign.
Not for that.
That's the diving museum. You alright?
Can we dye your beard? Because if we dye the beard to match that hair, that would look great.
Look great?
I've always fancied dyeing.
Look, there's part of the gun position up there. Look at this stuff here.
Oh yeah, that's one of the
things
you can
hold
on to.
Yeah.
Isn't it?
That's good, isn't it?
So Chris, you wouldn't need a swim, you could just hold on to it and then you could See, that would be alright, I'd be up for that.
Does it say how fast it can go?
It's called 3 mil.
Oh, the battery allowed for 4 hours endurance at 3 knots. Any faster and it'd be unworkable.
But how fast is 3 knots?
Yeah, I wish I'd say in.
Right now.
Is it?
Yeah. Oh wow, look at that thing.
That's cool.
You wanted a diving suit?
That is cool. That's got to be really old, hasn't it?
1939?
German.
Oh, is it?
500 feet, though.
That is shocking, isn't it?
You're going to get in it, then?
I would like to have a little stand in that, it'd be nice, wouldn't it?
Built in Germany in 1939, it was the third generation of its design. In practice, it was of limited use because the joints leaked in shallow water and seized up at depth.
That's reassuring, isn't it?
Like that.
So not only that, but you're in a metal thing and you can't really move very much and it fills up with water.
Yeah.
Brilliant.
And you can't see it, but there's a skeleton inside that. That's his last movement, folks.
But the suits, they achieved fame when they were used to successfully recover silver and gold from the wreck of SS Egypt, which sank in 1922.
Oh, wow.
So, the previous type, because this is a... What do we say this was?
Newer version.
Newer version.
This is cool. We've got to go in this museum, man. This looks really interesting.
We have to come over at some point. That's really cool.
Yeah.
So, that's a little tank that goes down, and they can take off their masks and that underneath, because obviously that top sucks up little air voids.
Yeah.
Which, that's really cool.
That is really good, actually. Go it down to any depth, really, isn't it?
Well, maximum operating depth is 50 metres.
Yeah, not Titanic depth, folks.
That's quite cool, though.
Ingenious.
Under normal conditions, one diver remains in the bell to act as a safety diver in case of the emergency while the other diver goes out to work.
Mm. Wow. Interesting.
I like that. It's good to have a sign. Yeah. So I hate it when you go to a museum and they don't have signs on.
There's a path up there.
Oh, no.
That's another diving bell type thing. 1956. Maximum depth.
Wow.
1,060 feet.
What, that thing?
Yeah.
You can see the glass though. Look at the thickness of the glass on that.
Yeah. It's got to be thick to the pressure, innit?
Yeah.
Wow. See, when it's maintained at an atmospheric pressure, that means when they come back up, they don't have to.
Decompression.
That's the bends otherwise. Yeah.
And they don't have to use goats.
Funny enough, yes. We went to a place recently. That actually adds up. So they must obviously have a lot of diving history around here. Which is why they were obviously doing experiments with goats.
Oh, right.
At depths, were they?
Look at these things here. Reclaim.
Its history was very significant. It was installed in 1965 on HMS Reclaim. The Royal Navy's dedicated diving vessel. The unique capability of the bell was that it could lock onto a depth compression chamber on board the ship to allow the divers to move from the bell into the chamber without changing pressure.
That reminds me of the one on the Doctor Who episode, actually.
That's
John Pertwee. Look at this.
North Sea. Saturation there, 1970 to 1990.
There's something about this stuff, I love it.
They're really old, this is like 90s and it's...
It looks like it's...
I wonder if they've been repainted though.
Yeah, oh yeah.
That's been on the
side. Maybe they worked their way along, you know, one a year or something. But you can see, look, the benches and stuff like that. So when the museum's open, you can obviously walk around these.
Yeah. 1970 to 1990, folks, that one. Look at it. Rusty as hell. You gonna get any pictures, Chris? Or Instagram, folks?
I didn't even think about it. You need to remind me of these
things.
Wow, 690.
Yeah, compression on. Chamber.
We'll do the museum at some point, shall we?
Yeah. Look at these. I like the look of these. I'd love to go inside that and just see what it's like. Should be alright. Yeah, as long as it's not underwater, folks, eh?
That's a short one, isn't it?
Yeah. Look at that.
Is something this sort of size?
Look at them sitting in that chamber there, the bottom one.
Oh, look. From the Royal Liverpool Laboratory.
Later Quinter.
Yeah.
Oh, wow. So that must have been one of them buildings up there somewhere.
Yes, they possibly had something like this down there.
Oh, look at that.
Oh, look. It actually tells you here. In 2001, we split up Fort Road, which is where we were, relocated. So they relocated. Yeah.
Oh, Christ.
So that's where they were, and then they moved.
Yeah.
Because their new site's over the road, I believe.
Ah, isn't it?
Well, interesting.
Nice, there's history together, haven't they? All ties up, isn't it? It's weird how they vary, some of them don't go down every day.
No.
341 foot.
Looking at the old spanners, and obviously not spanners, but they look like spanners.
Yeah, to lock.
Yeah.
And then they tighten down on the nut.
Yeah.
So a lot of this is from the trading days, isn't it?
Yeah.
What's around there then, in the trees?
There's a part like a river.
Oh, is there?
Yeah.
Actually, they've got the red flag.
That's probably
the bit that
we want to
say,
I think.
It
might be down. So, firing range, folks. Risk of fire, folks. Respect all warnings and closure signs. Yeah. No red flags today, folks, so we're all right. All right, Tom's got the maps out, folks. He's leading us to the locations. So got another gun battery over here. We don't know whether it's in the actual MOD site at the moment. But we've got to have a look, see what's happening. Might be a walk-in job. That over there is the Isle of Wight, folks. It actually looks quite amazing, actually, looking over there. As soon as I looked out the front of the car, that was it. It was like, wow, eye-opener, Isle of Wight. Get the ferry over there. A few explorers over there, folks. Right, I wonder. This place looks pretty tight on security, folks. What do you reckon?
Oh, hang on, no, look at the front.
The fence is different there at the front.
We have to walk back this way anyway, haven't we?
Yeah.
It looks like a vent, doesn't it? Like, it might be a sewage.
That's a vent, that's a very big something.
It looks like a bomb-proof cap tarp one. What the hell is this? That's definitely a... That's definitely a vent for sewage or something, isn't it?
What do you mean, Ian? Is there a ladder?
No, I was talking to Ian. There is. It's in the van.
Oh.
Maybe later on. We're not far away.
Yeah. Have a little look down there.
I'm curious what's in there.
Can you hear water?
Storm drain or something. Why has it got a vent on the top?
It's very big.
It is big. Bomb! Bomb proof.
Oh, hang on. Right.
Yeah, chuck a stone in there. That was awesome.
Look, the first one, straight in. Come on.
Sounds slushy.
It does sound slushy, yeah.
What's she thinking? Can we not push you up the wall?
Possibly if I stand on his shoulders.
Go on then, Tom.
I sort of went here.
It's a bit high, mate. Ladder would be better, wouldn't it?
Right, so we'll be back on that one later, folks. Join us then. Let's have a look for holes in this fence.